Okay, here's the parts that I have left over from stripping the antennas. I have a boom, a couple of insulators, two end caps, mounting bracket, save some of the UHF elements that were straight, mounting clips for the antennas, for the antenna elements, and then we have our stock for our 2 meter and 6 meter elements. So let's start with the boom. At this point, the boom length, after I cut off the end of it where that bracket was mounted, the boom turned out to be 56 5/8 of an inch long, or 1.438 meters. And the next step is, I've taken notes. I want to show those to you, if you can see them. And I've drawn out three antennas, the 2 meter, the 70 centimeter, and the 6 meter elements. And so what we're going to do is mark the boom for all of the elements. I like to use tape. Now you could take a Sharpie and mark directly on the boom, but I like to use tape because I not only use it to mark, but I also draw and take notes, make notes on the tape. The side with all of the holes, I think we're going to use that as the side of the boom, and the side without as many holes is going to be the top. And I'm going to go ahead and put a piece of tape across here like this. And we'll just go ahead and mark this top. Side. Now, let's start with our 2 meter elements. We've got enough room that we could probably get 5 elements on that antenna. I think, though, because with the parts that we have to work with, I think we've got eight clips. We've got enough parts for 4 elements on 2 meters and 4 elements on 70 centimeters. So we'll just stretch out the elements a little bit and turn it into a 4-element 2-meter beam. So if we stretch out 4 elements, it's about 45 inches long between the reflector and the second director. So, our boom length is 56 5/8, and we've just measured down a little ways from the end here, about 5 13/16. Make sure we're on the side. And do all your measuring from one end. This is the end where I have the bracket at, and so I'll know to measure from that end from now on. Okay, 5 13/16. Right about there. That's where our first element is going to be. Second element. I'm going to use a yardstick instead here. Because from the reflector to our driven element is going to be 15 inches. We'll measure down to 30 inches. And then we need another 15 inches down here at the end. And that would put us pretty close, pretty even right there, pretty even spacing. Go ahead and mark that 2 meter reflector. Let's put it up here on the top. As we peel off this tape and start adding elements, we're not going to know which hole is which. It looks like we could almost reuse some of these holes. Looks like we could use a set here and not have to drill this out. Because I've got where I have three of my marks, I'm pretty close to, there's already a hole there that's pretty close to 15 inches apart. So I think we'll just adjust this a little bit, move the antenna elements a little bit up. And we'll just mark them where these holes are at. So instead our reflector, 15 inches from where this hole in the tape already exists, right there, which is only half inch difference. So that'll make it a little easier on us. Our next mark up is up here. Up here. So, we've reused three of the holes and we only have to drill one for 2 meters. Now, we've got to figure our 440 elements. Our 2 meter elements are going to go on one side of the antenna. And the 70 centimeter elements are going to go on the other side of the antenna, on the other side of the boom. The fed element is going to be in the same place on the opposite side. So 70 centimeters and 2 meters is going to be fed, both fed right there side by side. I'm just going to take another piece of tape. Fed element is right here, which is now my elements are going to be spaced 6 inches apart, or about 15.2 centimeters. Now some of you guys may do that a little bit differently. I did not use any antenna software to calculate this out with. 6 inches up and another 6 inches. I've got one hole here that's about 3/4 of an inch, or I mean about 1/4 of an inch away from our mark. We could try to get by and use that, because it is right next. That would be a problem drilling that. So I think we will. We'll go ahead and use that for a reflector. We'll mark that reflector. This is D1 and D2. And we'll drill holes for those two. So on the 70 centimeter side, we've got a reflector. It's not quite 6 inches. We're going 6 inches apart with the directors. And the next step is the 6 meter elements. And we go back to our top side here. And we're going to measure in 1 1/4 inch. Our insulator that we're going to use on 6 meters is about 2 1/4 inches wide, and from the center hole to the end it's about 1 1/8. So we'll come in at least 1 1/4 inch and mark that. And this is the 6 meters, and this is the reflector. All of our reflectors are on one side. The antenna is going to be facing this this direction. And we come over to the other end. We can go ahead and turn, flip it around, and just measure up 1 1/4 inches. Which is about 32 millimeters. And finally we'll just take, we'll use a ruler here, and we just need to find the center at 1/2 inch. Give it a little mark, and mark